Hello everyone. Today I'm going to start trigonometric ratios based questions. Good mnemonics I have given. Sine, cosine and tangent ratios in a right triangle can be remembered by representing them as strings of letters, for instance. See, soka toa. Okay, SOHCAH and TOA. So how will you read? Sine is equals to opposite upon hypotenuse. Cosine is equals to adjacent upon hypotenuse, and tangent is equals to opposite upon adjacent. If you remember this one, so it is very easy to write all the formulas. Okay, so let us see. SOH, the abbreviation stands for sine is equals to opposite upon hypotenuse, and CAH stands for cosine is equals to adjacent upon hypotenuse, and the tangent TOA, T-O-A stands for tangent is equals to opposite upon adjacent. And some strings of letters are also there, words are also there. See the first example. Studying our homework can always help to obtain achievement. So we can take the first letter of each word. So it will form this one, soka TOA. And the second one, some old horses chew apples happily throughout old age. Here also we can take the first letter of each word. And the next one is some old hippie caught another hippie tripping on acid. And some old hen caught another hen taking oats away. So these are the some strings, some tricky sentences through which we can remember the formula. But the very easy one is this one, soka toa. Okay. Okay, now some picture mnemonics is also there with respect to this one. And with respect to this angle, this is the opposite side, this is the adjacent side, and this is the hypotenuse. So we'll write with 2O opposite side, 2A for adjacent, and 2H for hypotenuse. We'll start from here. See, this one, O to H is nothing but this is sine. Okay, sine theta O by H, right? Now A to H or O to A, three are there, O to H, O to A. Next one is left, A to H, this is tan cos theta. Tan theta is equals to O by A, and cos theta is equals to A by H. Okay, so any doubt in this, let me know. Okay, fine. So now let us see one question. If one trigonometric ratio is there to find the other trigonometric ratio. Okay, so sec theta is equals to 25 by 7. So first we will draw one rough triangle ABC, right triangle. Okay, and angle B is equals to 25 degree. See this figure. Now sec theta is equals to H upon hypotenuse upon adjacent, that is AC upon AB. Okay, and AC upon AB, it is given 25 by 7, right? So 25 by 7, it is the ratio. So we'll take AC is equals to 25 by 7 is the ratio. That is why we are taking AC as 25K and AB as 7K. And I told you that in the regular class also, if you write direct 25, 7, that is also board will give marks to you. Okay. बट क्योंकि यहाँ पे रेशियो में इसलिए मैं यहाँ पे के ले रहा हूँ. नाउ आई वांट टू फाइंड बीसी. हाउ विल यू फाइंड बीसी?
पाइथागोरस थ्योरम.
राइट, वेरी गुड. बाय यूजिंग पाइथागोरस थ्योरम. सो बाय यूजिंग पाइथागोरस थ्योरम वी विल गेट एसी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू एबी स्क्वायर प्लस बीसी स्क्वायर. नाउ बीसी स्क्वायर विल बी इक्वल टू, इफ यू शिफ्ट एबी स्क्वायर टू दिस साइड, विल गेट एसी स्क्वायर माइनस एबी स्क्वायर. Now substitute AC and AB. So 625K whole square is 625K square, and this is 49K square. We are getting 576K square. So what is the square root of this one?
24K.
Right, very good, 24K. So BC we got 24K. Now we'll start with all the trigonometric ratios. So let us start with sine theta. Sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. So which is opposite to this theta? Which side is opposite?
BC.
BC, right. And which is hypotenuse? AC. So sine theta is equals to BC upon AC, and BC is 24k and AC is 25k. So 24k upon 25k, you can cancel k and we'll get 24/25. Any doubt in sine theta?
No sir.
Okay.
Now cos theta. Cos theta, no need to take adjacent upon hypotenuse because sec theta is already given. So we can take the reciprocal of sec theta. So what is the reciprocal of 25/7?
7/25.
Right, 7/25. Okay. So now tan theta also we can use sin theta upon cos theta formula, or you can use opposite upon adjacent also. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे मैं sin theta by cos theta formula use कर रहा हूँ. Sin theta is 24/25 and cos theta is 7/25. So this 25/25 will be cancelled. Okay, and we'll get 24/7. Or we can take 24 opposite by adjacent, that is 24k upon 7k, that is 24/7. Any formula you can use it. Okay, so now cosec theta. Cosec theta is the reciprocal of sine theta. So 25/24. And only one is left, that is cot theta. Cot theta is the reciprocal of tan theta. So cot theta is equals to 7/24. Any doubt in this question?
No, sir.
Okay. So now we'll have some selected questions from exercise 8.1. Let us start with the first question. See, here in this question, only two sides are given and some trigonometric ratios we have to find. So let us draw the diagram first with the right angle at B. And BC is given 7 cm and AB is given 24 cm. And in order to find sine and cos, we required hypotenuse. So how will you find AC?
By Pythagoras theorem.
Very good. By using Pythagoras theorem. So AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. And AB is 24 and BC is 7. So we'll substitute the value of AB and BC. 24 square is 576. And 7 square is 49. So 576 plus 49 is 625. So what is the value of AC?
25.
Very good. So AC is equals to 25 centimeter. Now let us start with the sine A. Sine A. Now with respect to A, which side is opposite?
BC.
BC, right. And adjacent?
AB.
AB. Okay, that you have to remember. Now sine A is O by H, that is BC upon AC. So 7 upon 25, this is the sine A. Now cos A is adjacent upon hypotenuse, A by H. So 24 by 25, this is sine A and cos A. Now with respect to angle C, which is opposite?
AB,
right. And adjacent is BC. So sine C means AB upon AC. So 24/25. And cos C is A by H, that is adjacent by H. So which side is adjacent to angle C?
BC.
Right. So BC upon AC. And BC is 7 and AC is 25. So we are getting 7/25. Any doubt in this question?
No, sir.
Okay. So we'll see the second question also. Second question also based on the same. But here we have to find the value of expression. This is another type of question. So PQ is given 12 and PR is given 13. We need to find QR. How will you find QR?
By Pythagoras.
Right. By using Pythagoras theorem. So in triangle PQR, angle Q is 90 degree, PQ is 12 centimeter and PR 13 centimeter, that we'll write first. Okay. And using Pythagoras theorem, we are getting, what we are getting using Pythagoras theorem?
PR square is equal to PQ square plus QR square.
Very good. PR square is equal to PQ square plus QR square. Now we'll substitute the value of PQ and PR. Okay, and we need to find QR. So we'll substitute, we'll shift this to this side first. So minus ho jayega. Now 13 square minus 12 square, 169 minus 144, we'll get 25. So what is the QR then?
5
centimeter, right, very good. Now we need to find tan P and cot R, okay? So we'll find first tan P. Tan hota hai O by A. So opposite side of angle P is?
QR.
And adjacent?
PQ.
Very good. So tan P is equals to QR upon PQ. And QR is 5. We got 5. Ye 5 mila hum log ko. And PQ is 12. So we'll get 5 upon 12. Now cot R. Cot R. Cot is A by O. Adjacent. Which side is adjacent to R?
QR.
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 And which is opposite?
QR. PQ.
PQ.
PQ. Right. So we'll get QR upon PQ. And QR is 5 and PQ is 12. So we are getting 5 upon 12. Now what is the expression? Well, what is the value of this expression?
Zero.
Got a.
Tan P minus cot R is equals to 5 by 12 minus 5 by 12. That is equals to 0. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. So third question also I would like to take. Uske baad hum log dusre questions pe concentrate karenge. So if sin A is equals to 3 by 4, calculate cos A and tan A. If you remember, this question I have given in revision test number 6, but in place of cos A, sec A was there. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we'll make first triangle. Okay. Sin A is given 3 by 4. So sin A is, sin is opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite is BC. Okay. And hypotenuse is AC. So we'll take 3K, 4K. Okay. So how will you find AB then?
By Pythagoras theorem.
Very good, by using Pythagoras theorem. So now we have to find AB. So we'll shift BC to this side. So it will become minus. So AB square is equals to AC square minus BC square. We can take square root also and substitute the value of AC and BC. So 16K square minus 9K square. We'll get 7K square. 7k square, that is root 7k. Okay, now find cos A. Cos A is adjacent upon hypotenuse. Which side is adjacent to this angle?
AB.
Right, AB upon AC. So AB upon AC is root 7k upon 4k, that is root 7 upon 4. So sec A ka value find karna tha, to 4 by root 7 tha, wo wala jo answer tha. Now tan A. Tan A is opposite by adjacent. So opposite is BC and adjacent is AB. So BC by AB, that is 3K upon root 7K. 3 by root 7. Any doubt in this question?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, given 15 cot A is equals to 8, find sin A and sec A. So 15 cot A means what is the value of cot A? 8 by 15?
8 by 15.
Right. So cot A kya hota hai? A by O, adjacent by opposite side. Right. So we'll draw one triangle first. And adjacent is AB. So that is why I wrote 8K. And opposite is BC, 15. Okay. So AB ko 8K lenge aur BC ko 15K. Now we'll find AC by using Pythagoras theorem. So AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. AB is 8K and BC is 15K. So 8K square is 64K square. 15K square is 225K square. If we add up, we are getting 289K square. So what is the square root of 289K square?
17.
Very good, 17K. Okay, now we'll start with sin A. Sin A, which side is opposite to angle A?
BC.
BC. So BC upon AC, right? That is 15K upon 17K, 15 by 7. This is the first answer. Sec A. Sec A, adjacent, hypotenuse upon adjacent. Which side is adjacent to this angle?
AB.
AB. AB. Right? And hypotenuse is AC. So AC by AB. 17K by 8K. So we are getting 17 by 8. Any doubt? Okay.
No.
Now we are going to start question number 9. In triangle ABC, right angled at A, if tan A is equals to 1 by root 3, find the value of this two expression. Okay. So first of all, this can be done in two ways. Okay, दो तरीके से कर सकते हैं इसको. मैं पहला तरीका बता रहा हूँ जो रेगुलर वे है. विद द हेल्प ऑफ टैन ए विल फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन ए कॉस ए साइन सी कॉस सी. ओके, रेगुलर मेथड. सो दिस इज द डायग्राम एंड व्हाट इज गिवन दैट टैन ए इज इक्वल टू 1 बाय रूट 3. सो टैन ए इज हियर एंड टैन इज ऑपोजिट बाय adjacent. Which side is opposite to this angle?
BC.
Adjacent?
AB.
AB. So BC upon AB is 1 by root 3. So BC will take K and AB will take root 3K. Okay. And we'll find the value of AC by using Pythagoras theorem. That is AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. So root 3k whole square plus k square. We'll get 3 plus 3k square plus k square, that is 4k square. So what is the value of AC then?
2k.
Fine. 2k. So we got 2k. Now we'll find first sin A cos A sin C cos C. Uske baad substitute karenge. Okay. So we'll start with sin A. Sin A is O by H. So, which is opposite to angle A?
BC.
BC.
So, BC by AC. That is K upon 2K. Right? K upon 2K is 1 by 2. So, we got 1 by 2. Now, cos A. Cos is adjacent upon hypotenuse. So, AB upon AC. That is root 3k upon 2k. So root 3 by 2 we are getting. Okay. And next we have to find sin C and sin cos C. So sin C with respect to this angle, which is opposite?
AB.
Right. AB. And hypotenuse is AC. So root 3k upon 2k. That is root 3 by 2. Next, cos C. Which side is adjacent to this angle?
BC.
BC, right. So BC upon AC. So K upon 2K, that is 1 by 2. Okay. So any doubt in finding these values?
No, sir.
Right. Just now I told you that another way is there. So the value of tan A is given 1 by root 3. And 1 by root 3 tan ke kaun sa angle mein aata hai? 30 degree. So angle A is 30 degree and angle C will be 60 degree. Whether this is clear?
Yes, sir.
What is sine 30 degree?
1 by 2.
1 by 2. Very good. Cos 30 degree?
Root 3 by 2.
So sine A cos A you can get from that values. Okay. Now sine C cos A. Sine 60 degree.
Root 3 by 2.
And cos 60 degrees 1 by 2. Okay. So you can get the values using that method also. Uske baad ka jo step hai, wo common step hai. We'll find the value of sin A cos C plus cos A sin C by substituting all the values. This is the first bit. So sin A was 1 by 2. Cos C is also 1 by 2. And these two are root 3 by 2. So this will become 1 by 4 and this will become 3 by 4. Now if you take LCM, we'll get 1 plus 3 by 4. So what is the final answer?
1.
Yes, 4 by 1. 4, that is 1. Second bit, cos A cos C minus sin A sin C. So we'll substitute cos A root 3 by 2, cos C 1 by 2, sin A 1 by 2 and sin C is root 3 by 2. So both will become root 3 by 4, root 3 by 4. And the answer is 0. Okay. Any doubt in this question?
No, sir.
Okay.
Now see, I told you two methods. Both methods are correct and you will get full marks if this question will come. And easy method is this 30 and 60 degree. Okay. Right. Now we'll move towards the next question. This is 10th question. Very good question. In triangle PQR, right angled at Q, PR plus QR is equals to 25 centimeter and PQ is equals to 5 centimeter. Determine the values of sine P, cos P and tan P. So first we will make one right triangle PQR, right angled at Q, and in which PQ is given 5 centimeter. And the sum of these two sides is given 25 centimeter. Okay, so what we will do, we'll use Pythagoras theorem. According to Pythagoras theorem, we are getting PR square is equals to PQ square plus QR square, right? And PQ value is given 25, so it will become 25. And RQ, QR, we can write QR is equals to 25 minus PR. This is clear? QR के जगह पे हम लोग 25 minus PR लिख सकते हैं. So if you substitute, you will get this one. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay. So 25 minus PR whole square, we will use A minus B whole square formula. So A square plus B square minus 2AB. See, PR plus QR 25 दिया हुआ है. PR को हम लोग यहाँ shift करेंगे तो minus PR हो जाएगा. ठीक है. नाउ ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर माइनस टू ए बी, सो विल गेट दिस वन. दिस विल बिकम 625 एंड दिस विल बिकम 50 पीआर. ओके, नाउ वी कैन एलिमिनेट दिस टू. ये दोनों को एलिमिनेट कर सकते हैं या ये दोनों को यहां शिफ्ट कर लो. यू शिफ्ट दिस साइड. ओके, इफ यू शिफ्ट दिस टू दिस साइड इट विल बिकम माइनस पीआर स्क्वायर प्लस 50 पीआर. And this two will become 650. Whether this step is clear?
Yes, sir.
Now you can cancel these two. You can cancel these two. So 50 PR is equals to 650. What is the value of PR? 13 centimeter. So if PR is equals to 13 centimeter, QR will be 25 minus 25 30. Minus. Right. That is 12 centimeter. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay. Now we have to find sin P, cos P and tan P. So we'll start with sin P. Right. Now sin P is O by H. Which side is opposite to angle P?
QR.
And hypotenuse is PR. So sin P is equals to QR upon PR. So what is the final answer? 12 by 13. Okay, cos P. Which side is adjacent to this angle?
PQ.
So cos is adjacent by hypotenuse. So PQ upon PR. So final answer is 5 upon 13. Okay, tan P. Tan is O by A, opposite by adjacent. Which side is opposite?
QR.
And adjacent is PQ. So we are getting QR upon PQ, that is 12 by 5. Any doubt in this question?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, I took selected questions from first exercise. Now, I'm going to take some CBSE questions. So, let us start with the very good question, 2018 board exam ka question hai hai. If 4 tan theta is equals to 3, find the value of this expression. Okay, so we required sine and cos from here. From tan theta, we have to find sine theta and cos theta. सो ट्रेडिशनल मेथड बोले तो फिर हम लोग को ट्राइंगल बनाना पड़ेगा, वी हैव टू मेक ट्राइंगल, राइट? सो टैन थीटा इज ऑपोजिट बाय एडजेसेंट, दैट इज ए बी अपॉन बी सी. सो क्योंकि रेशियो है इसलिए 3k या 3x ले सकते हैं, 4x. सो यहाँ पे मैंने 3x लिया है. सो ए बी इज इक्वल टू 3x एंड बी सी इज इक्वल टू 4x. नाउ वी नीड टू फाइंड ए सी by using Pythagoras theorem. So AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. Substitute the value of BC and AB. 4x, 3x. Right? So 16k x square plus 9x square, 25x square. So what is the value of AC?
5.
25.
Right, 5x. Now sine theta and cos theta we required. So sine theta is equals to we got here 5, na? Yahan pe 5x aa gaya. Sine theta is O by H. So 3x by 5x, that is 3 by 5. You can write directly. And cos theta is, what is the value of cos theta?
4 by 5.
Right, very good. 4 by 5. Now we'll take the expression and we'll substitute the value. Okay, 4 sine theta minus cos theta plus 1 upon 4 sine theta plus cos theta minus 1. We'll substitute the value of sine theta and cos theta. Now take LCM. If you take LCM, you will get 12 minus 4 plus 5 upon 5. 12 plus 4 minus 5 upon 5. So this 2, 5, you can cancel it in the next step or ek step ke baad aur cancel kar sakte hain. So what you are getting here? 13, and here we are getting 11. So 13 by 5 upon 11 by 5. Now 5, 5, you cancel it. So final answer is 13 by
13.
11. Right. Any doubt in this question?
No, sir.
So now we are moving towards the next question. This is a CBSE 2011 question. And 3 cot theta is equals to 2 is given and we have to find the value of this expression. 2 sin theta minus 3 cos theta upon 2 sin theta plus 3 cos theta. Okay. So first of all, what is given that cot theta is equals to 2 by 3. So what will be tan theta? What will be tan
theta?
3 by 2. Yes, tan theta is 3 by 2. Now, how will you get tan theta from this expression? Can you identify? Tan theta pe kaise milega?
Sin theta by cos theta.
Right. We have to divide by cos theta. Okay. So, that concept is clear. So, yes, dividing sir. Numerator and denominator by cos theta. See, dividing numerator and denominator by cos theta, what we are going to get? Here tan theta will come and here 1. Tan theta 1. See. सबसे पहले हम लोग स्प्लिट करेंगे इसको. इफ यू स्प्लिट, दिस विल बिकम टैन थीटा एंड दिस विल बिकम वन. दिस विल बिकम टैन थीटा एंड दिस विल बिकम वन. सो माइनस थ्री प्लस थ्री. दिस स्टेप इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू?
यस सर.
ओके, फाइन. नाउ दिस क्वेश्चन कैन बी डन इन दिस वे ऑल्सो. यू कैन डिवाइड इट बाय साइन थीटा ऑल्सो. सो इफ यू डिवाइड दिस एक्सप्रेशन, इफ यू डिवाइड दिस एक्सप्रेशन बाय साइन थीटा, you will get here 2 and you will get here cot theta. So 2 minus 3 cot theta numerator, and what you will get denominator? 2 plus 3 cot theta. So aisa bhi kar sakte hain aur aisa bhi kar sakte hain. Now you can substitute the value of cot theta in this expression without converting into tan theta, right? This is one way and this is the another way. Now I am going to substitute tan theta here, that is 3 by 2. So 2 into 3 by 2, this 2, 2 cancel. And what I am going to get? 3 minus 3 upon 3 plus 3. That is 0 by 6.
0.
And the final answer is 0. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay. So now we'll move one more question. This is 2012 question. This is also to find the value of expression based question. So 4 cos theta is equals to 11 sin theta. Find the value of 11 cos theta minus 7 sin theta upon 11 cos theta plus 7 sin theta. So what you have to do first, how will you write it by tan theta or cot theta? Tan theta kitna hoga isme? See, cos theta you shift to this side and 11 you shift to this side. So you will get sine theta by cos theta is equals to 4 by 11. That is tan theta, okay? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. That is tan theta. If you want to convert it to cos theta, cot theta. So shift this 11 to this side. Sine to this side and 4 to this side. So you will get cot theta is equals to 11 by 4. But I want tan theta. So sine theta upon cos theta is equals to 4 by 11. Already I explained isse pehle. So tan theta is equals to 4 by 11. So how will you got tan theta here? By dividing by cos theta, right? So dividing numerator and denominator by cos theta, we are getting this one. So yahan pe milega 11, only one, kyunki cancel ho jayega. 11 minus 7 tan theta upon 11 plus 7 tan theta. This expression is clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Now substitute the value of tan theta as 4 by 11. Okay, now take LCM. This will become 121 minus 28 upon 121 plus 28. 121 minus 28 upon 11. 121 plus 28 upon 11. So 11, 11, we can cancel it. So the final answer is 121 minus 28 upon 121 plus 28. So 93 upon 149. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay. So we'll see one more question. This is 2009 board exam question. If cot theta is equals to 15 by 8, then evaluate 2 plus 2 sine theta into 1 minus sine theta upon 1 plus cos theta into 2 minus 2 cos theta. So this can be done in two ways. Pahla, cot theta se sine or cos nikal lo, then you substitute here. Otherwise, you can use tricky method. How will you solve this question? You can take two common from here. Yahan se two common nikal lo, yahan se two common nikal lo. To ye kya bachega aur ye kya bachega batao. What about this one? Ye kya bachega if you take two common?
1 minus cos theta.
Down 1 minus cos theta. What is up?
1 plus cos theta.
1 plus sine theta.
Sine theta.
Right. 1 plus sine theta. Okay, fine. So that is clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now see, if you take 2 common. Right. If you take 2 common, we are getting 1 plus sine theta here, 1 minus sine, 1 minus cos theta. What you will get if you multiply these two?
1 minus sine square theta.
Very good. And here? If you multiply these two?
1 minus cos square theta.
Very good. What is 1 minus sine square theta? And this 2, 2 cancel. This 2, 2 cancel. What is 1 minus sine square theta?
Cos square theta.
Very good. What is 1 minus cos square theta?
Sine square theta.
Right. So we are getting cos square theta by sine square theta. Okay. And what is cos square theta by sine square theta?
Cot square theta.
Very good. Cot square theta. And cot theta is already given. So cot square theta is nothing but 15 by 8 whole square. And what is 15 by 8 whole square?
225 by 64.
Right. 225 by 64. This is the answer. Any doubt? Any doubt here?
Sir.
Okay. So I told you three types of questions. One is to find trigonometric ratios if other trigonometric ratios if one is given. Second, to find the value of expression. These are all value of expression. And the third one, proof related question. So for proof related question, let us have one question. So this is very good question, 2013 board question. If tan theta is equals to a by b, prove that this is equals to this. Right. Okay. So we'll take left hand side first. Now how will you get tan theta from here? How will you get tan theta from here? How will you convert it into tan theta? क्या करेंगे हम लोग इसको cos theta से डिवाइड करेंगे ओके विल डिवाइड न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर बाय cos theta सो विल गेट दिस स्टेप इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू यस और नो
यस सर
यहां पे cos theta कैंसिल हो गया एंड दिस विल बिकम tan theta एंड दिस विल बिकम tan theta सो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू गेट a tan theta माइनस b अपॉन a tan theta प्लस b Now substitute the value of tan theta. This step is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, substitute the value of tan theta. So this will become a square by b minus b upon a square by b plus b. Take LCM. If you take LCM, you will get this one. Now you can cancel this b and b. So what we are going to get? The RHS. This is the RHS. Hence proved. Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So proof related question is also over. And now let us move towards the last section that is assignment question. Okay. So assignment question mein these two are based on the first one. That is if one trigonometric ratios is there is given and find the other trigonometric ratio. This is to find the value of expression. This is proof related question. Okay, so please take the screenshot of this assignment question. Taken?
Yes, sir.
और एक जन हम लोग के मैथ्स वाले व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप में डाल देना. Okay, so that's all for today's session. Thank you. Thank you very much.